More factors make me challenge. First, kyphotic thoracic curvature. With the aging process, the kyphosis becomes severe, and cranial and caudal angulation of the CM becomes bigger. It means technical difficulties. The second factor is the multiple bony structures that block the needle pathway. The rib, transverse process, and wide laminar are the culprits. I have to admit that I have faced some technical difficulties because I had less chance of practice and little experience before finding the advantage of the contralateral oblique image. The laminars are vertically oriented and compactly wrapped in layers, and there is only cilia-like interlaminar space in the thoracic spine, so there is no alternative way to reach the epidural space, unlike the cervical and lumbar spine. The transforaminal approach is the best way. Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. Today, I show you a thoracic transforaminal epidural steroid injection technique. I'll perform it under CM, AP, ipsilateral, and contralateral oblique image guidance. My target will be the T9 right intervertebral foraminal space and count down from the T12 body. It is the T9 level, and I found a large osteophyte formation on the right side. The alignment of the inferior end plate of the T9 looks good on AP view, so I'm going to rotate the right ipsilateral oblique position. Usually, I rotate the CM until I can find the target and the suitable needle pathway. The transforaminal approach is more difficult in the thoracic spine compared to the lumbar and cervical spine. I think the contrast spread is okay. I'll show you the contrast media spread on the contralateral oblique image. Please keep the contrast pattern in mind. Previously, I mentioned the yellow line connecting the internal aspect of the pedicle. Finally, I'll administer steroids. I always use high concentration of dextrose solution as a solvent instead of normal saline. I know most pain interventions